Welcome to the online practical sessions. This is experiment 8 of second PUC, that is semiconductor diodes. Of experiment 8, there are two parts in which I will be considering only the forward bias part. That is, we will be doing the forward bias part of the semiconductor. In semiconductor, we have both forward bias and reverse bias. So we'll look into only the forward bias for today. The aim is to draw the current versus voltage characteristics curve of a PN junction diode in forward bias and hence find cut-in voltage. We'll now understand what do we mean by forward bias and what do we mean by cut-in voltage. Here is a representation of a diode, PN junction diode. In a diode, we have P-type on one half and N-type on this other half. And at the junction, we have immobile charge carriers, negative charge carriers on the P-type and positive charge carriers on the N-type. They are immobile. They have formed a bond, and this now constitutes a barrier potential, and it has a potential of nearly V naught. For silicon, it is nearly 0.6 volt or 0.7 volt. A diode starts conducting current when you connect the P-type to the positive of a battery and N-type to the negative of the battery. Then current would start to flow, and current starts to flow only when this barrier potential is being overcome. So I can keep on increasing the voltage in the battery. When the voltage in the battery has overcome the barrier potential nearly 0.6 volts, only then current starts to flow. So we will verify this in today's experiment. We'll connect a battery, also connect a voltmeter across the diode, and to measure the current, let us connect an ammeter. We'll be taking the reading of the current versus voltage and find out when the current increases as voltage increases. So the principle tells, when diode is forward biased, it offers very low resistance, and cut-in voltage is the characteristic voltage at which diode current increases exponentially even for a small increase in bias voltage when the diode is in forward bias. We can understand this principle when we perform the experiment. We will see that current increases in the diode after crossing a certain voltage, which is called as cut-in voltage. We'll find out the cut-in voltage. Also, a diode is symbolically represented by a triangle with a bar at the end. The beginning here represents the P-type, and the bar on the other side represents the N-type. So this is the symbolic representation of a P-N junction diode. Let's look into the circuit now. Here is the circuit diagram to perform today's experiment. A battery is being taken and a diode is forward biased. The battery positive is connected to the P of the diode, and the other side, the N-type of the diode, is connected towards the negative of the battery. Today, using a rheostat, we'll be changing the voltage or the potential difference across the diode, and therefore see what is the current. So we'll be studying how current changes as potential across the diode changes. And practically, a diode is just a small black color bead with a white band on one side. The white band on one side represents the N-type. The other end is going to be the P-type. This is how a practical diode would look like. So this is the observation needed to perform the experiment for today. So let us make the circuit connections. Here is the experimental setup. I have a battery, an ammeter, diode. I have a small bead like thing. This is the diode. For the sake of experimental connections, I have mounted the diode onto this terminals. Voltmeter, rheostat, and a plug key. So let us look into the circuit diagram now. Let us start making the circuit. First, the battery positive goes to one end of rheostat, also The same thing goes to positive of ammeter. Let us make these connections. The battery positive here is connected to one end of the rheostat. So the positive is connected to one end of the rheostat. Also, from the same positive end, we connect to positive of ammeter. Next. Now, the negative of the ammeter is connected to the P side of the diode. Also, the same one goes to positive of the voltmeter. So let us make these connections from negative to P of the diode and to the positive of voltmeter. Here, this is the diode, which is very small in size, which is less than a centimeter in length. On this diode, when you observe closely, you will have one side a white band. The white band side is the N-type and the other end is going to be the P-type. So let us make the connections. From ammeter negative, we have to connect to diode positive, sorry, P-type of the diode. And from the same junction, also to voltmeter positive. Next. Now, from voltmeter negative to N-type of the diode, also the same voltmeter negative goes to rheostat. And this is the variable contact of the rheostat. So let us make the connection. Now, from the N-type of the semiconductor to negative of the voltmeter, also from the same negative of voltmeter to the variable contact of the rheostat, we have two more contacts here. The upper contact is the variable contact. We will connect here. Next. Now we are left with one end of the rheostat to the key and other key to battery negative. We'll make these two connections. Now connect the third terminal of the rheostat to the plug key and finally from plug key to the negative of the battery. Before we start the experiment, the plug key is always been open and the voltage here, I've already set it to nearly 2 volts and we are ready to perform the experiment. The circuit connections are over. Let us recall it. First, from battery positive to one end of rheostat and from the same battery positive, I have connected to positive of ammeter. Next, from ammeter negative to P type of the diode, also from the same end to positive of the voltmeter. Next, from voltmeter negative to inside of the diode and then from the same negative of the voltmeter to the variable contact of the rheostat. Finally, from the third terminal of the rheostat to the plug key and from plug key to negative of the battery. So now let us plug in and let me change the reading in the voltmeter. You see, as I move the rheostat contact, the voltage in the voltmeter changes. So also the current reading in the ammeter. Let me begin with 0.1 volt. Now, the reading in the voltmeter is 0.10 and the reading in ammeter is actually, it is still 0. There is a small experiment instrumental error. It's 0. It is showing negative, but it is 0. Let me continue. Now, let me increase the voltage to 0.2. The voltmeter reading is 0.20 and the current here is still 0. Now, the voltmeter reading here is 0.30. And the current is still 0. Let me increase the voltage further. Now, the voltmeter reading here is 0.40 and the current here is still 0. The voltmeter reading here is 0.50 and the current reading is still 0. The voltmeter reading is now 0.60 volts and observe the current has now started to increase and the current now is 0.9 milliamperes. I'll note down this in the table. Let me further increase the voltage across the diode. Now observe, the voltage across the diode is 0.70 and the current reading is showing 8.6 milliamperes. I will note down this in the table. Let me further increase the voltage. Observe the readings in the ammeter. You will see, even for small change in voltage, I only increased from 0.7 to 0.72. But the current has increased from 8.6 milliamperes, it has now jumped to 14.2 milliamperes. Let me try to get the voltage here to 0.80. Now, the voltage reading is 0.80 and the current has increased to a greater value. It has increased exponentially to 82.7 milliamperes. Once you get the current readings in multiples of 10, you can end the experiment. And we will now draw a graph, and the graph will explain the characteristics of the diode in forward bias. The table here helps us in understanding the current and voltage characteristics of a diode in forward bias. You see here, initially as I increase the voltage from 0.1 to 0.2 to 0.3 to 0.4 till 0.5, the current in the diode was zero, because there was a barrier potential in the semiconductor diode, and that barrier potential did not allow current to pass through the diode. And when the voltage across the diode was 0.6 volts, now this 0.6 volts has just overcome the barrier potential, and we have got a small current of 0.9 milliamperes. That's a very small current. Once you overcome the barrier potential, at 0.7 volts, I am now getting 8.6 milliamperes. Increase further the voltage to 0.8, the current increases to 82.7 milliamperes. Even for small increase in voltage, the increase in current is exponential. So this is how a diode works in forward bias. As you overcome the barrier potential, the diode now becomes a very good conductor of current. The same is been shown here graphically. We have taken voltage readings along the x-axis and the current readings along the y-axis. Till 0.5 volts, the current is zero. The diode has not started to conduct yet. At 0.6, the diode has just started to conduct. And at 0.7, we have 8.6 volts. So we have plotted a point at 8.6 volts. And for 0.8 volts, the current has increased or shoot to 82.7 milliamperes. This is showing exponential increase in current. And I get the 0.7 volts here as cut-in voltage, the voltage at which the current increases exponentially. The same I have drawn even in the graph here. Let us look at this. The IV characteristics is been plotted in the graph. We have taken voltage along x-axis and current along y-axis. Until 0.5 volts, the current is zero. At 0.6, the diode has just started to conduct and the current has just started to flow. At 0.7 volts, the current reading is 8.6 milliamperes. So a plot is being drawn here. And at 0.8 volts, the current is 82 milliamperes nearly. So the plot is being put here. And if I draw a curve from 0.5 to 0.6 and after 0.7, the current increases exponentially. The point at where the current increases exponentially is noted down as cut-in voltage. Also, we have noted down the scale. On x-axis, every centimeter is representing 0.1 volts. You can see here, for every centimeter, it is 0.1 volts. On y-axis, every centimeter of line is representing current of 10 milliamperes. Here, every centimeter is increased by 10 milliamperes. So every centimeter is representing 10 milliamperes. In this way, the characteristics of the diode in forward bias is being shown in the graph. Finally, we are left with noting down the result. We will end by noting down the result. The result says the cut-in voltage of the given diode is 0.7 volts. So we have successfully completed part A of the semiconductor diode, that is diode in forward bias. In part B, we will look into the diode in reverse bias. Thank you.